Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic commodities market. So this topic is for your SEBI grade examination. So guys, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. Now let's begin. So first of all, I will log into our website anujjindal.in. Now I will log into our website. So here you need to go to the quizzes section. So you can see here quizzes are available for different examinations: RBI grade B, SEBI, UGC, NET, NABARD. So I will go to SEBI grade A. So here I will go to the securities market, commodities market, start quiz. So let us see the first question. What do we call the situation when spot price of a commodity is lower than the futures price? So there are two prices, spot price and futures price in case of derivatives, right? So the spot price, it is the price of the underlying asset on which the derivative is based, and futures price, it is the price of the derivative which is being traded on an exchange. So they are asking the situation when spot price is lower than futures price, right? So this situation, it is called contango. So a term is given to this situation, it is called contango. So the correct option is option C, but let us see the other terms as well. So option A is backwardation. So what is backwardation? Backwardation is opposite of contango. So if the spot price is greater than futures price, then it is called backwardation. Another term is convergence. So this I will discuss in the next question. Then contango, then basis. Basis is the difference between spot price and future price. And cost of carry, cost of carry and basis are the same. So the correct option is option C, contango. Now next question 2. What do we call the process by which futures price converge with physical prices at the expiration of the futures contract or delivery date? So you know that futures contract, they are for a specific maturity. So let's say 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months. So they are for a specific maturity. So as the contract reaches near to the maturity, the futures price and spot price, they start converging. So you can draw a diagram for this. So the futures price and the spot price, they basically converge near the expiry. So through this diagram, you can see that the two prices, they converge as the contract reaches maturity. And on the settlement date or the expiry date, futures price become equal to the spot price. So on the expiry date, the two prices become same, right? So this process, it is called convergence. So this process is called convergence. So the correct option here is option B. Next question 3. Through a circular issued on June 18. So this is not 2018, it is June 18. So through a circular issued on June 18, 2019, SEBI has permitted recognized stock exchanges with commodity derivatives segment to introduce dash on commodity indices. So this is a recent circular. So this is important also for your exam. So you know there are stock indices. Similarly, there are commodity indices. So recently SEBI has permitted recognized stock exchanges which have commodity derivative segment to introduce futures contract. So basically to introduce futures contract on commodity indices. So stock exchanges who want to issue futures contract, they have to seek approval of SEBI, and also these exchanges need to submit at least past 3 years data of the index on which they are proposing to introduce a future. So at least past 3 years data on the index constructed, it needs to be submitted to the SEBI while seeking approval, right? So here the correct option is option B, futures. Now moving on, question 4. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding various examinations is being shared. So do join our Telegram group and get the benefit. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. Now question 4. Consider the following statements. So you are given here 3 statements. You have to see which of them is correct and which of them is incorrect. Statement 1. ICOMDEX is the flagship index series of MCX. So MCX, you know, it is multi-commodity exchange. So this statement is right. ICOMDEX is the flagship index series of MCX, and this series is developed by MCX jointly with Thomson Reuters. Statement 2, NCRISI is a value-weighted index computed using the prices of 10 most liquid commodity futures. It belongs to NSE. Now statement 2, it is incorrect, because NCRISI, it is an index of NCDEX. So NCDEX, it is the second largest commodity exchange after MCX. So NCRISI, it belongs to the NCDEX and not NSE. And NCDEX, you must know that only agriculture commodities, they only trade on NCDEX, right? So future contracts are available only on agricultural commodities on NCDEX. So NCRISI is the index of NCDEX. So statement 2 is not correct. And statement 3, BSE is the first listed exchange of India. This statement is again incorrect, because the first listed exchange of India is MCX. So MCX, so the shares of MCX, they are listed on both BSE as well as NSE. So MCX is the first listed exchange. So statement 3 is also incorrect. So the question is asking you, which of the above statements are correct? So only statement 1, it is correct. So the correct option here is option D, only statement 1. Now next question 5, Forwards Market Commission, FMC, used to be the regulator of commodities market, but it has been merged with SEBI. Now SEBI is the regulator of commodities market as well. In which year FMC got merged with SEBI? So FMC, it was established in 1953 through an act. So it was the regulator of commodities market from 1953 till 2015. But since 2015, SEBI is the regulator of commodities market. So since 28th September 2015, SEBI is the regulator of commodities market. So FMC, it has merged with SEBI, right? So the correct option here is option D, 2015. Now next question 6. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that we have also posted this quiz on our website, as I have just shown you in the beginning of the video only. So you can visit the website and attempt these quizzes. So quizzes are available on other topics as well. So do attempt these quizzes and see your preparation level. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now question 6. Consider the below statements regarding commodities market in India. So here you are given 3 statements regarding commodities market. You have to see which of them are incorrect. So first of all, statement 1. Forwards Market Commission is the regulator of commodities market in India. So this statement is incorrect. As I just told you in the previous question, that now SEBI is the regulator of commodities market. FMC was the previous regulator. Since 28th September 2015, SEBI is the regulator of commodities market. Statement 2, SEBI has recently permitted recognized stock exchange with commodity derivative segment to introduce futures on commodities indices, and exchanges need to submit past 3 years data of the index while seeking approval from SEBI. So this statement is right. So this I have told you in one of the previous questions only, that SEBI has recently permitted exchanges to introduce futures on commodity indices, and they also need to submit past 3 years data of the index. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, MCX CCL is the first clearing corporation in the commodity derivatives market. So this statement is right. So MCX CCL, it is the clearing corporation of MCX. So MCX CCL stands for Multi Commodity Exchange Clearing Corporation. So it is the first clearing corporation to get approval from SEBI. So statement 3 is right. So the question is asking you, which of the above statement is incorrect? So only statement 1, it is incorrect. So the correct option is option C, only statement 1. Now question 7, this is the final question. Which is the largest commodity derivative exchange in India? So your options are NSE, BSE, MCX, NCDEX and NCME. So I am not going to tell you the answer to this question. So you need to mention the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards I will post the correct answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.